Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Di video ini saya ingin mempresentasikan tentang jurnal Development of Volcano Warning System for Cloud Volcano yang ditulis oleh Maria Elvita, Aska Zakiatudin, Sensius Seno, Nina Siti Amina, Wahyu Sri Gutomo, Irwan Melano, Aris Tiawan, Erlan Darmawan, Imam Suyanto, Irzaman, Muhammad Yasin, Ferdinand, Retna Apsaris, Wahyudi, Wiwit Suryanto, dan Mitra Jamah. Di video ini saya ingin mereview bagaimana dari jurnal tersebut. Yang first introduction. Indonesia lies within the ring of fire of Asia Pacific volcanoes and has 129 active volcanoes. As an endemic small trough volcano, Mount Cloud is one of the most active and often destructive volcanoes in Indonesia. It not only has hazardous explosive eruption but also short explosive eruption, waste lava, lahar, pyroclastic and acid magma with high gas concentration from an addictive. This volcano is located at 756 and 112 ATE in East Java at 1731. I'm above sea level and 1650 m about populated area in the Kediri and Blitar district. After its first eruption in 1000, the oldest known eruption in Indonesia, the largest eruption took place in 1589, 1641, 1828, 1999. 1919, 1951, 1966, 1990, and 1214. The total number of casualties of this eruption was more than 200 people, 200,000 people from 38 villages surrounding the volcano. Together with damage to livestock, building, infrastructure, agriculture, either way. The damage was caused by high energy release 2.2 equal 109 during the 2014 eruption and 3x108 during the 2007 eruption from the magma traveling at high velocity over 200 milliseconds in a Permian eruption. Methodology. First, smart sensor system. The fixed mode sensor nodes consists of a CO2 sensor, MG811, a SO2 sensor, TGS2602, a temp 02, a temperature and humidity sensor, DHT11, a seismicity sensor. Second, LoRa and LoRaWAN. LoRa is a frequency modulation format using phase shift keying and frequency shift keying transmission with a stable frequency value. This low cost, both in terms of purchase and power consumption, radio can be implemented for long range application until 100 mil with high capacity and security using end-to-end AES 128 encryption, and also for geolocation. In this research, this M2M, machine-to-machine communication method was used for the transducer of the transmitter and the receiver. 3. Solar cell and battery. A renewable energy source was used to the power supply in this research, employing a solar cell which is suitable for Indonesia with all year sunshine. The harvested electric energy was stored in a battery as semi-cell energy. 4. Drone. A quadcopter equipped with a gimbal, 12 MP camera and a 50x70 mAh drone battery from DJI was used for this research. This Phantom 4 Pro series drone was controlled using the Phantom 4 Pro software on a smartphone along with a DJI Go application. After image has been taken by the drone, which flies following a flight plan, they are exported to the software to build a 3D model and orthophoto for further analysis. 5. Mobile robot. A robot with a proportional integral derivative PID control using a skid steering mechanism robot operation system ROS, real-time operation system RTOS for kinematics and dynamic was used to acquire Volcano parameter data, SO2, CO2, temperature and seismicity while in mobile mode. And next, result and discussion. First, seismicity. Raw data in the form of acceleration versus time were computed using the fast Fourier transform, FFT for frequency domain transformation. Hereafter, they are presented as their root mean square value after calculating the power spectral density, thus and spectral component contribution for each frequency can be analyzed. 2. Gas concentration. The sulfur dioxide concentrations slightly varied between 0.298 and 0.465 ppm, similar to the carbon dioxide concentration, which varied from 0.306 to 0.391 ppm. According to the datasheet, these ranges are categorized as noise, where the typical detection range is 1 to 10 ppm for SO2 and 300 to 10,000 ppm for CO2. Therefore, there are no contaminant gas were measured during this observation and the volcano was in normal condition. In the future, more data processing using a suitable filter will be done before the data are presented for analysis. 3. Temperature. It can be seen from the map in the figure 8 that the temperature of the crater lake varied between 29.5 Celsius and 55.3 Celsius. 6. Volcano warning status. Based on the field data for SO2, air temperature and seismicity, SVG input data for fluidification process, SO2 was at normal level, seismicity and air temperature was also at normal level too. Solar cell and battery. Generally, the data was well accurate between 11 and 12 a.m. LoRa and LoRaWAN. In this research, we placed the sensor node and control station 400 feet apart. And last, conclusion. A volcano warning system for Mount Kulut was developed. The system could detect a number of physical parameters of the volcano in normal condition. i.e. seismicity, gas concentration, SO2 and CO2 under 1 ppm and temperature 23 Celsius to 55.3 Celsius for the lake, 32 Celsius for the ground, and 23 Celsius to 25 Celsius for the air, which indicate that the system worked properly for about 37 hours in full operation mode until the battery had to be charged using the solar cell. However, the state of filtering the raw data is still needed before the data are presented by represented for further analysis. In addition, a more powerful antenna should be used in the future for better data communication. For the last acknowledgement, the author would like Indonesia Collaboration Research Riset Kolaborasi Indonesia 2019 and 2020 from Institut Teknologi Bandung, Universitas Gajah Mada, Institut Pertanian Bogor, and Universitas Erlangga for funding the research. Baik, sekian presentasi dari saya. Kurang lebihnya mohon maaf. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.